We are part of a baby boom generation. We were born after our parents lost everything in Cambodia. Once they came to America, our parents put the past behind them and never talked about it. In my family, I'm known as the lucky one. Years later, I realized how lucky I really am. I was born on the Cambodian New Year in a refugee camp. My parents never told me much more than that. Before I was born, everyone in my family, my parents, my two older sisters, my brother, all survived the Cambodian genocide. In 1975, a communist group called the Khmer Rouge came to power. The leader, Pol Pot, wanted to create a perfect society. But instead, 2 million people died. After my parents escaped and moved us to Texas, they focused on giving us a normal American life. But who are they kidding? They never left Cambodia. My mom still cooks on the kitchen floor. My dad trims trees with a meat cleaver. And he lays around watching Cambodian karaoke. They're Buddhist, but we celebrate Christmas every year. It's Socheata. I want you to come outside Bong Lat's house.
Ah. Oh, Merry Christmas!
Last year, I came home for Christmas, and my mom had all of her kids under one roof. Suddenly, my mom called a family meeting. In a back bedroom, she told us a secret she had been hiding for 25 years. My mom said that my two older sisters aren't really my sisters. My brother isn't my full brother. And my mom had a husband before my dad. I had a million questions in my head. But before I could open my mouth, my dad ran out of the room.
He kind of get choked up and went and sit on the toilet in my bathroom.
He had a breakdown moment. And I had to get him out of there.
Bong Lat went and yanked him off the toilet.
My parents and even my sisters kept this secret from me for 25 years. I felt like I didn't know my own family, and I wondered what other secrets had they left behind in Cambodia. After the big family secret was out, my mom invited my brother and me to Cambodia for the first time. They wanted us to meet our relatives, but I saw it as a chance to finally get what happened to them before I was born. I knew more about the Holocaust than the Khmer Rouge. I knew even less about my family's story. My mom was married before my father. She already had two children. Her husband and daughter died during the Khmer Rouge, leaving my brother Scott. Then my mother's beloved sister died, leaving two orphaned nieces. My mother adopted them and raised them as my sisters. At some point, she met my dad and had me. But when or where she met him, I have no idea. I wanted to know how my parents, this mismatched couple, came together.
What do you like about Ba?
I like about Ba when he not talking.
When talking not like.
Yeah.
What do you mean?
He's a good listener. He's a good listener.
So Ba, what do you like about Matt?
Yeah. I like her. Ba's like that, Ba's like that, you're right.
This was my chance to finally understand what my parents went through. Making a film gave me the excuse. I had no memories of Cambodia, so I read every book I could find about its history. Growing up in America, I only heard of it as an afterthought of the Vietnam War. In order to stop the Viet Cong from smuggling weapons through Cambodia, America dropped more bombs on Cambodia than were dropped on Japan during World War II. The Khmer Rouge, the Red Cambodians, emerged from the jungle to overthrow the government. On Cambodian New Year in 1975, they marched into the capital city, Phnom Penh, and told every citizen to leave. My parents were there.
We have radio on, and we heard the radio announcing by Khmer Rouge, say, we took over. My dad was strong believe that, say, pack anything you can pack. So we did. I mean, food, enough for at least a week or two. What we can carry, we take all of them.
Chia chân chanh vì quanh những co phải tung mà liên phi liên nữa nè.
Everybody panic and you scared to death when you see the black uniform.
The Khmer Rouge wanted to create a classless society. They forced everyone into labor camps. They canceled Cambodian New Year and renamed April 17th Cambodian Liberation Day. When we arrived in the capital, Phnom Penh, I didn't see any signs of a destroyed city. Cambodia was trying to move on from its past. The Khmer Rouge had blended back into society. And most Cambodians don't remember that time. Three quarters of the population is my age or younger. As soon as we got settled, my mom agreed to take me to the labor camp where she spent 3 years living under the Khmer Rouge.
This is my skill. I have good skill. The reason he survived because he not die.
That's not a good answer. Expand on that.
Tang mon ha yeung trou kit mich tha yeung kom kla han pe kom khlaj pe yeung plau ka ta plau ka ta ke tha tau thau da tau ta thau kit
kwat always bo tha min kai ao ke teu mon kwat neu ka da dat pa yeah he always like someone get you know knock the door ring doorbell at night he let me get up and answer the door instead of him
is that true
it is yeah. true 100%
yeah
see ពូប៉ាខ្លាចថាមិនមិនមកស្លាប់មុនចុះ
ទុកឲ្យប៉ាតស៊ូកូ
ន You see that?
At the labor camp, Matt seemed anxious, rushing out the door.
ប៉ណ្ណឡូវហូហូងនេះទៅនៅសល់នេះមួយនឹងពេតដែរហ្នឹងឲ្យដល់ដល់ភូមិនៃម៉ាក់នៅនេះនៅនោះប៉ណ្ណឥឡូវគាត់ហ្នឹងមូទៅកកោហើយយើងទៅកកោទៅជួបគាត់ចលងចលងខ្ញុំទៅនៅចលងនោះមករយៈដែរញ៉ាចលងហ្នឹងបានបងយកមិនស្លាប់ហ្នឹងមកទៅទៅទៀតហើយទៀតហើយកូន
We spent all day to get here, but we only stayed 3 minutes. My mom put up a brick wall, just as she had done my whole life. When I was a kid, I remember asking my parents, "Who are the Khmer Rouge?" But they always dodged my questions. I was left to my own imagination. In my nightmares, I saw the Khmer Rouge, faceless men who were out to get me. I tightened my eyes and hid beneath my pillow. The Khmer Rouge lurked in the shadows, but I could never see their faces. Though my sisters, Mala and Lakina, refused to return to Cambodia, they could finally share their story. My mom had told them to keep silent for 25 years, and now they were relieved to talk about their first family again.
What does your father do?
He works for the bank, that's all I know. I know he had a motorcycle. He rode the motorcycle to and from work. Sometimes he took me to work with him. I thought that was cool and then I got to work with him because he kind of showed me off, you know. And my mom, she's just a plain housewife. Very loving.
I don't think she's a talker. I think she's just really quiet and reserved and just take care of people around her.
Like all Cambodians, Mala, Lakina, and their parents were forced into a labor camp.
I didn't remember seeing anything there but rice field. When rice starting to ready for harvest, they said, now they don't belong to you anymore, they belong to Angka.
Angka simply meant the party. Angka turned the entire society upside down. Angka owned everything, your land, your labor, even your children. It controlled where you lived, what you did, what you said, what you ate, and even what you thought. Pol Pot, the Khmer Rouge leader, hid behind the word Angka like it was a person. But Angka didn't exist, so no one was in charge, and no one was responsible.
I was with Monglet sometime. Sometimes we could find like bodies, you know, that were executed the night before or something like that. It's like they're not trying to hide anything. You know what I mean? Just there.
I did run into dead bodies. And, you know, so I do know what it smells like as far as decay body and stuff.
At one of the camps, the first night, my dad, they took him away. That was the last time I ever seen him. They took me away from the family, put me in the children's camp. And you're in the rice field and you're wet all the time. And sometimes you end up going to sleep wet.
Sometimes there's food for us to eat, sometimes there's not. So you line up to go get food, but then they end up give you just a piece of rock salt. Sometimes you just lick that to sleep. Maybe if you're asleep, you won't be hungry. And I know some kids and people, adult too, that sometimes when they go to sleep, they don't wake up.
I had all the skin infection on me, and that's why I had all the fever. And then my mom, she came looking for me. She packed her lunch, you know, her food in a banana leaves, you know, to come looking for me. And I don't know, that afternoon she found where I was. She didn't even know where I was. She found where I was. And then she told me, she go, I have not eaten, you know. I'm waiting to find you before I eat my lunch. And then she saved part of her portion of her food for me. She's the reason I'm alive.
A quarter of the population died in 4 years from starvation, disease, and execution. No member of the Khmer Rouge has been brought to trial. The Prime Minister, himself a former Khmer Rouge commander, said it's time for Cambodians to dig a hole to bury the past. I didn't understand how a whole country could suffer through this and not demand justice. After the resistance I got from my mom, I gave in to why my parents brought us here, to visit family.
Did you always have a lot of food to eat?
Yeah, no problem for food.
What kind of?
Before I come, it's okay.
Did you have a lot of cows and?
Yeah,
food?
I have a lot of cows. I cowboy. I cowboy long time.
You're a Cambodian cowboy.
Yeah.
I'm afraid it's gonna cut my feet.
No, not cut.
Okay. Oh, oh, okay, whoa. I didn't, oh, bah, bah. What if it kicks you? This is the cowboy, come on back.
did a place for my born here.
You were born here?
Yeah, I was born here.
How can you remember it? There's no signs or houses or anything?
Yeah, I know that in a tree in here.
Uh-huh.
It's 100 years already.
This tree?
Yeah. And yeah, no more.
There's nothing left.
Nothing.
My father was an ex-soldier in the Cambodian army. The Khmer Rouge told family members to turn each other in. His family didn't, but they had to distance themselves from him.
My cousin. Chúng bong tàu bây giờ nó. Tập theo ấy.
I learned that my mom lost 30 family members during the Khmer Rouge. She wanted to make sure my brother and I met her relatives who stayed behind.
My sister is right here.
Got the mask on. Sao mình chứ? Hả? Ơi khi em đâm thay ơi phẹp chị em phòng.
Anh đâm. Anh em phở hơn nặng. See your cousin.
We met my aunt, second cousins, cousins, and more cousins. And for the first time, my brother met his father's side of the family.
I feel
This is the first relative of my dad that I've met.
My brother saw his real father's face for the first time.
That's the same exact smirk. Mm-hmm. It's like that mischievous look.
Mm-hmm.
That, you know, he's thinking I'm doing something bad or something. That, like, right there, that's me.
His mother. Huh. How do they still have all of these pictures?
When Khmer took over all this, because they're not allowed to have all these pictures, they bury, they hide really good. I mean, that includes golds and jewelries and, you know.
And they went back and got it.
Everything. They, I mean, there's a lot of things they bury.
We found this photo of my mom's first wedding. I'd never seen her as a young woman before. She married a man from a rich Chinese family like hers. They lived together in an apartment in Phnom Penh.
I'm trying to remember. Tôi chia. Bạn chẳng có mặt đưa lên score và. Ai thử sinh sinh. Bà ấy nó chưa chăm giống ấy.
Chăm nó. Chăm chăm nó.
Nhóm tôi ấp ấp chứ ba. Ấp chứ ba, I don't remember. Nothing familiar anymore.
My mom's memories were fading. The places had changed. We couldn't find any trace of the good life she used to have. Matt shared a lot of happy memories with her first husband's family. In my mom's second marriage, she seemed to have nothing in common with my dad. And part of it had to do with the color of his skin.
Why is Bab obsessed with being white?
Oh, he's real Cambodian and
mixed Chinese.
Mixed Chinese better.
More educated,
high class, and richer, and I mean, better looks and everything. Yeah.
I mean, Ba is dark.
But he's still considered dark bad. He hates dark.
Skin color was just a symbol of how far apart they are. It was always a mystery how they got together in the first place.
Do you remember when you met Matt?
Matt? No, không được bồi nghĩa. Về lúc ba khởi sắp hơi Matt. Và là ngay ta ba, tại ba ắt cho chết Matt, ba ắt lại sẽ đây hỏi Matt thế.
Ắt cho chết? Why not?
Đăng mấy.
So when Ba said he liked you, what did you say?
I think it's not good for you. You go find someone else. And plus, you're too old for me. And Mak Dung Tha, family background, and we are both completely different.
Mak Kong Da Sai Ro, Papa Kong Da Sai Ro, Mak Da Chia Mok Mi. Thực ra chỗ nghĩa, Mak Da Chia Ta Đấy, nghĩa nghiêm luôn.
I was getting two completely different stories from my parents, but it was better than no talking at all.
I'm not going. Thought did I? Why you had to follow me out?
My mother was getting tired of my constant camera. So was my dad. No one wanted to cooperate. Matt kept saying their story wasn't special, and she suggested making a travel film instead. For a while, I pretended to go along with it.
Oh, so am I. That's the Cambodian nose there. It's my nose.
After all the sightseeing, we were exhausted. During a quiet break, I had a moment to ask my mom some questions. To my surprise, she started to open up.
What was life like under Khmer Kahom?
Like every day when I woke up still alive, thanks God that I'm still alive. And every day I see my relative, my family die one at a time. I'm so scared that all of them gonna die. Thân chân tóc mạ trẻ, chứ nó hơi tôi mạ bông là chân. See, mạ đừng được thả, mạ know how to get people attention. Mạ very good soft talk, and like me con chân mạ. Dì lo mấy cái slang mạ. Anh mà chửi đề ấy ở kia anh chẳng á. Tại chẳng tự ai always get something extra. One time nó mà cần sự nữa. Mẹ con she like a leader that group chẳng. She like me, I tell the story, movie story. And when I do that, she come to one of me, they listen to my story. Why she turn her face this way? Nè, để score này nó từ lùi mà nè mà bụp bụp and then đến lùi from me too. Tại đó vì cái chân lùi cái ta bằng hôn phép gì hướng con phép bom tia đó. Đó là ảo bị lùi.
So how did you meet Ba?
Meet Ba, couple both after his father passed away. My group and his group know each other, so the guy can you do each other, and then.
So you were arranged together by the
Khmer? Actually, I consider not, because they not put us together like that. We can't go together with them also.
I had the feeling that Matt was hiding something. It's the Khmer Rouge camp that my father was in, Pramalu. Is that it? Is that how
it's
you spell
actually,
it?
Yeah, Pramalu. Oh. It's a village.
Okay, okay.
So this week it's Bang Khna. And the village is Pramalu.
So you got your spell done. So you ask people, I think that's the only way that you can ask where the village is.
Because my mom was becoming more and more resistant, I continued the rest of the trip alone with my dad. He came for the chance to spend time alone with me, but I asked him because he's much easier to direct. We headed toward the labor camp where Matt met Ba.
So why do you think there are more bad guys now?
มันปีอะไรนั้นมนุษย์ก็กลัวเฉินดังนี้ไอ้มนุษย์ได้อัพเตอร์ขมายรู้เดอะคิลเดอะพีเพิลโซเดอะขมายรู้คิลเดอะขมายรู้สติลสเตย์โซเดอะบาปอีอัดคานอตซีบาปโซเดอะพีเพิลดองบลิวดองทราเดอะเดอะบอดี้บอดี้เซเดอะอูคิลบาป
So you still believe? I still believe. So, alone nung khai ko hom thoe bap. But ot ban bap win. Hai dai.
I don't know what going on.
I live over there.
You live over there?
Yeah, the home over there. Right there. I'm going to go to the store. I'm going to go to the store. ម៉ាក់ប្រាប់ថាយកមកកប់ចិត្តប្រគុណនៅចង់ទៅមើលកន្លែងហ្នឹង
ចាចិត្តប្រគុណហ្នឹង
ដល់គៀនទៅនឹងឯងថាមើលនូវប្រគុណនូវប្រគុណពីយូរយារណាស់ទៅដល់ម៉ាក់មកកាលមកស្អាតទៅរងៀបយកចូលទៅអត់បានចូល
ហើយមក
ថាចង់គោះទៅភាកច្រើនគេថាបើបានលើកន្លែងណាសុខហើយទុកទៅនឹងចុះមិនគោះទេគោសម្រាប់ចិត្តថាអត់គោះទៅគេក៏ស្លាប់នឹងស្លាប់អត់បាយអត់បាយឈឺឈឺរោរៀរៀមុនស្លាប់ហ chỗ mấy bít đưa ớt cái giới phôm ban đằng thứ ấy vô phía chán cái dây thật nó đã lại ná xuống lại sọc cái bái ai nâng nâng cho
just that night that she died somebody got Matt to come over
even she died chân Matt still sleep nơi cái nông vong như mỗi kia and mà ọt khlai chứ you know ọt khlai khmau chứ ọt khlai khmau
the next morning you know it didn't hit me I was like fine you know she died there's a man came over they prepare the body you know just like dressed her you know put blankets on her whatever and they roll her up in the tail and then he just carry her away when they took her body away I went and washed her clothes and that's when I just like I was crying at the river it's like she's actually gone she's dead you know
Did you ever talk to Khmer Kham? Is there anything you would want to say?
I don't want to talk. Well, I need it. I'm scared of my mouth.
If you could talk to one right now, would you? Hello, Nung.
Hello, Nung. Talk with Khmer Kham. Then Khmer Kham, Thai Na Phong. That's cool. Who is the Kham with the kill? Right now, I didn't know that.
But if you could.
I don't want to talk with him. I don't want to talk. I don't want to hear. I don't want to see. I hate.
I need to tell you what we're doing.
Tell you what?
Right now we're we have found a net like home.
They're here?
Mm-hmm. Nhưng còn ở trong nhà chúng tôi quạt. Nhưng còn ở trong mơ mơ quạt.
Ta quạt điểm mấy vậy?
Yeah.
Okay, good.
You okay with that?
Yeah.
You come with me?
I can't come with you. It's okay.
Once when I asked my dad about the worst part of living under the Khmer Rouge, he said it was the silence. I wanted to break that silence and confront some of the people who made up my childhood nightmares. But I was terrified. Mom Tep was the deputy chief of the Khmer Rouge hospital where people were brought to die.
And what was your motivation for working for them and being a part of the Khmer Rouge?
My guide interrupted the interview when he learned that Mom Tep was in charge of the hospital.
Mình khả năng là bệnh khá là tầng đó.
Khá tầng.
Và hay khả năng bọn xây khá nhóm hay năng mặt ai khá nhóm. Trời bắn xa lập nơi khu nông một tí bệnh năng đài. Nhưng mà đang thả ta ở nơi một tí bệnh năng. Ta cá thuốc ba cao vì mình ao trong này hát ta miết ai tiết ta mình lắng. Nam y văn mình
oi cục con phòng, ọt miết tam phòng.
Kê
ọt thông miền tập nặng kê. Hãy tham tham dương tham cọp đang mơ ai chè tham rửa chờ rửa prey nè ngon mơ bật chè tham một ngày mai mày muốn tham mày muốn tham bẹt bẹt cái vô tàu đặt cả tiền tàu cầm não cọp cọp chầu bẹt á thì cọp chầu tham nè chẳng đặt tầng tham nè
khi nhưng các bạn chưa quạt mà ăn sẵn nơi chỉ bụi quạt mà dục hai bấy tháng ngày tràn máu mà đại khi nhóm con được nâng thang quạt sẽ làm và nhóm tay là món năng rõ khác nhưng tay đã khơi nơi lại một ốc máu tay kỳ tay đã ôm mà được tay cọp là tin luôn.
Would you like to say sorry to this man who has lost loved ones?
Tôi thơ bạch bờ kể bắt đón ôi chân màu hơi dục miền na miền bò bó mặc bóng buồn đọc thầy nè hay mình ngọt hay tham mình ăn tục tuần tuần nữa
mình chẳng mình sống tốt quá tớ
còn lâu sống tốt này bạn phục mặt nam của ai chẳng sống tốt thử mình.
So Paul, do you accept?
I'm not the real accept, but I don't know how to deal with this situation. But I wish never happened again, and I very sad memory, very, but I don't know how to say.
We also found San Seum. He was a district chief in charge of 300 families. He also controlled the labor camps where my parents worked.
Do you ever believe in the philosophy? Did you truly believe in the philosophy of the Khmer Rouge?
From good kind of art with young art on a ring, panya, twerka, cats, the government, good plate, fried him car, good all beer. When one took the light to the aug of one tire to that smart with a car tan and I caught him in command. Come on, now something when something often clang clang, but I caught that thing.
Men mag a light to the hot dog yet I cut. Mục đó miền đồng nang kháng bộ phía nên bộ phần mùi nữa vô tốt bánh cho thế này phụ phán phán hết bây giờ chuẩn đăng thẳng vô bánh cho hơi mình ngọc cô lưu khó nói nhưng mình bây giờ chuẩn bị bà can có bị bà môn ông vô bà môn ông
but I cannot see
I hear, I heard.
You heard the killing?
I heard somebody tell me.
Are you haunted by the memory of the thousands of dead?
Mình nè mẹ khi ở rộng khơi thì cả khó xuống cứ không ở phía tốt ngọt. Cả khó xuống lưu không lưu rụp để cục luôn bởi chứa cho nông sản có nhưng mà cả khó xuống cái thứ ra. Xong một tư thật đó thứ mấy cô cá sẽ mấy tụng ọt nếp. Không bọn nó được cắt tôi ta. Bọn nó bóp được về mặt chân. Ở đằng thang lấy bụi xa rứ. Nên nó ồn à cỡ. Bởi tụng chân tôi nước ôi bởi vật xa bọc mấy về bắt. Không phải plate bằng plate cầm sai rồi. Oh, cầm trắng lắm, trắng là xuống đó.
What was the reasoning behind separating families and forcing marriages?
Nói âm miền chẳng không? Âm miền chẳng miền anh chơi. Lúc ông cá bậc sức diễn trong bàn cụ xa bà kỳ xu dùa tàu. Bàn kìa bác thu o đâu. Thả ạc tân trong bàn đi chơi cho bàn đất cá. Bạn đâu có không nên xích riêng ở cái tàu mà tàu hết á. Muốn được bố, ôi đọc bằng phêl, dọa đọc bằng phêl, mùa than, chạm vô chạm, chân vô chân. Đó phêl vẹn tí tí, từ lúc đó, ôi dùa, xu nạ cả mà, nó bên đầm nạ cao với chân. Ở bên hầu cái chạp đạn ấy, cứ ra, cái tàu, tạ tình hết á. Đấy là tình đoàn thế nâng.
So, Pa, were you forced to marry Matt? Is that what happened to you as well?
Yeah, when the Matt, if the husband died.
You can make my own.
They got slapped though. I got to move money. Money to marry Pippa. And got me and gone jump pina. Gone got moy. Gone jump nung. You come moy.
Yeah. So how did you accept this marriage?
Yeah, I accepted her. So I am not dull. Malalia. Which never part of the tool near the chief at the oh, young law, I smile.
How did they marry you? Did you come in front of Khmer Rouge and they just said you're married or are you in a big room with a lot of other couples?
No, not too big room. Just a thin more and yay, perhaps how married to more near even near that song. No big room.
It takes 1 second?
Yeah, not too long.
Did they make you sign anything or?
No, not sign anything.
The Khmer Rouge forced my parents, two strangers, to marry because they were so different. After the meeting, my father collapsed in exhaustion. I thought about calling off the rest of the journey. Maybe I pushed him too far. I began to question my reasons for this trip. Was it to understand my parents, or was it just to ease my guilt about being the lucky one? Mom Tep, the Khmer Rouge woman, made food for my dad. She offered it to me as well. Even though I was starving, I didn't take it. I just wanted to leave. Most Cambodians went on with their lives like nothing happened. It was as if the life had been squeezed out of them until there was nothing left. Not even outrage. In 1979, the Khmer Rouge fell when the Vietnamese invaded Cambodia. Cambodians flooded out of the labor camps. My sisters, Mala and Lakina, who were lost from the rest of the family, were liberated from their children's camp. But they didn't know it.
I remember that one evening, all of us, hundreds or even thousands of kids, just lined up by group on the ground like that, sitting in line. And then my name was called.
I think Bong La, she realized that we're gonna be separated here. Well, so she stood up and she said, I want to stay with my sister.
And we get to leave together. You know who let us, like a 14-year-old, carry a rifle? They want to take the children to the mountains.
It wasn't a mountain.
It was like close to the mountains.
We had no idea whether they're going to kill us then or had no idea. They took us to this village.
And when we got there, we saw this lady and she told us, follow me. And she took us to this little one room, little cottage. So we climbed up there. It was just a mound of rice, almost to the ceiling.
Just a cottage of rice.
And so she's like, take what you can.
There's this rice. And I remember you told me, take off your shirt.
No, your pants. Tie the legs up.
Because I have short under.
It took us a long
time. So she tied the bottom of the legs.
And put the rice in there.
And then put the rice in there.
And then we couldn't pick it up.
And then you was trying to, okay, you stand up first. So I stood up and she put the rice on me. I dropped back down.
So we
slowly empty out the rice because we couldn't carry.
Because they told us to take whatever you can carry. And they basically tell us, do whatever you want to, you know.
When the Khmer Rouge disappeared, Ma and Ba were also liberated. They could have gone their separate ways, but my mom wanted to join the thousands of Cambodians fleeing for the refugee camps in Thailand. Ba offered to take her across the border, but my mom wouldn't leave without those two little girls. My parents went from village to village looking for my sisters. They depended on the help of friends who sometimes housed them and took care of my brother. My parents never forgot these friends, though they had been separated for 25 years.
นักเคยสกอเลยอัดสกอเลยปปนจีมาปนจีนี่กองเพ่ให้แบบนี้นั่งไงเออเจ้าจะนั่งกลางแว่อยู่มวยนั่งไงนั่งไงนั่งบ่นจะไล่จะอัดตั้งนั่งได้ไอ้
My parents asked every person they met on the road if they had seen my sisters, but there was no trace of them. After months of searching, my dad, by chance, found Mala and Lakina in a field digging for potatoes.
Oh, I was so happy! There's an adult, somebody that I trust, somebody I knew from when I was a kid, you know? It's like, I was so happy.
You're happy. You can actually hug and no one shoot you. You know, because you're not supposed to express love and affection or anything like that.
And Ma even told us that we can call him Pa. And I didn't know all of this back then. I just know that he disappeared for a little while. And he came back with a dead bird that he killed. And we had meat for the first time to eat. And I mean, right then, to me, he is my hero. And I just thought, wow, I had such a cool dad, you know.
You can't need a fatherly figure. And you kind of like to make a family complete, you know?
My father smuggled three children and my mother, now pregnant with me, toward the Thai border.
Sometimes we cross like field. They told us there's a lot of minefields in this area. Watch the people's footstep in front of you, trying to put your foot, and the people in front of you put your foot. I mean, and you could see dead people to the side, just like that, next to the path of where you're walking.
So he was what she needed to get all of us to a safe place. And he was the strength. He was the one that carried all the weight, you know. And I think he's the hero in a lot of people's mind.
So Pa took Bung La.
Bung La, Minh.
Yeah,
first time.
And second time.
Came back to Earth, to me and Bung Po.
And then third time.
Third time for him.
And then fourth time.
Oh, third time from Sunday, remember?
Okay, third time from Sunday,
and then fourth time for Kim.
So really, four times?
Mm-hmm.
Đây là anh lắc khai xá thực thầm cái thực thầm thực lâu thực từng cung nói tụt mạng mạng tàu những cành những cây phá miền là phố phi mà nhìn hiếng anh thằng cò nó cứ thằng cờ rồng so tôi nữa miền cò miền nắng phi mà nhìn hiếng.
We returned to the refugee camp where I was born, the very spot, but there was no sign of what was there 25 years ago.
In here?
Yeah, mà đông nắng ấy, bơi gió hỏi, nhưng mưa hòa mưa bình khơi.
These trees are new.
อัด miền snam ấy kêu rúc tích tí à. Pẹt nưng pẹt thơ 2 à. Bamboo à rơ vi bamboo hành.
Phọ
à slực.
Chà.
Pẹt mô rai chư pôh nưng. Chư pôh tăng pị mọng 8 mọng prực pâlâm lãng chư pôh hay. Yà chòm ngày tí 13 khai 4 ngày tí 13 khai 4 the Khmer New Year. Đó pel đó ngày pel can cứ tha mô bu mô mô phu mong chênh nga mong pa phnya đó con ta pet tha nhom tơ bai lết tha mô bính chênh nga ta pet hay mô hay con nhom cát hay mô nhom mô rồi cát mô ba ban thẹ phai chưng pa sấy ha pet pet tu mô ọt ban bai đó lị pru vô mô đó mong hảnh vuan yu yu rơ pê vuan sọc One sub tam culture Khmer, Cambodian culture. Mm-hmm. They said you nung mean bon. It's a good lap. Pale day. Mukham. Bon, I chong rung day no lupa. Past deep, I'm my Mukham, I Mukham day below. Sometimes you know that.
When con cat no Khmer culture kê thơ bon ai ye
kê thơ pê na con đ bong kê bơ cọ kê ha tha bơ cọ 3 ngày kê thâu chong đai ai cọ đâm bị ới
chong đai chmuay
đai nơ chong đai bơ chách chách ới pơ ai you good luck ai chăng đó na pơ nưng chi tùm niêm tùm lọp culture bơ Khmer.
Did you do that when I was born?
Oh well, sorry, I'm not.
That's okay. You did good, Ba. You did good.
It
doesn't work if you beat any other place in body. So, Ba, this was the. I have a surprise to give you. Yes. Well, it's for me too. We're gonna go to the Wat that's just next door to here, just close by. Yeah. And we asked them to perform that ceremony that you didn't get to perform when I was born.
Yeah, I'm going to go to the hospital.
After everything they've lost, I wondered what would give my parents peace. I asked my mom about justice. She said, who would they punish? Pol Pot is dead. Matt said, evil like this will not last. The world will turn right side up one day. Everything the Khmer Rouge sought to destroy, my parents instilled in their family.
What are all the people in customs going to think about this dried fish?
I just say this is a gift from my family.
What he did, and also I'm talking to him, you know, and explain to him, and he did it because he wanted to show me how much he loved me.
Who is to say who wins or who loses? Myself at the end of the day when I know what the blues is, and all my mistakes have become masterpieces. I was born in the goodness of grace. Because of faith, because of courage, because of forgiveness, all my mistakes have become masterpieces. And there there comes a time you must stay in the moment while your heart's still bleeding. And there comes a time when you must walk away though your heart's still beating. Myself at the end of the day when I know what the blues is. And all my mistakes have become masterpieces. All my mistakes have become masterpieces.